Her thoughts on the death of Osama bin Laden is South Florida Congresswoman Ileana Ruslan. And Congresswoman, good morning. Thank you so
good
much
morning.
For being
I don't
here.
Know how you guys do it so early in the morning every day.
But you know what? It's a big
I
news
had that
day.
Coffee,
yeah.
So I'm
yes.
feeling good.
That always helps. Congressman, where were you when you heard the news?
Well, I was at home and not thinking mm-hmm. that anything of this magnitude would happen when we get the call. They have a great operation center, the Situation Room with and the State Department Operation Room, where they start calling all of the Democratic and Republican leaders, so no one is kept out of the loop. But they don't tell us too much in advance of telling you guys we can't be trusted with information, rightfully so. And so we get told just a little bit before the rest of the folks get told. But what a jubilant call. I mean, everybody was obviously so happy to hear this, and it's really brought our nation together, just as we were together that horrible day almost 10 years ago on September 11th. But what's interesting about it is that we had already scheduled a dinner with President Obama for tonight, because we go back up to D.C. today, and it'll be interesting to see what the discussion will be about how this operation was carried out in a very tricky ally, in quotes, Pakistan, that's kind of on again and off again.
And that brings me to this question, because we're hearing of a fortress-like compound. We're hearing that it had 12 to 18 feet walls, topped with barbed wire, with two security gates, no telephone, no internet access. But we're hearing about this happening in Pakistan.
Yeah.
And the relationship you were talking about before, what does this mean? And do you believe that they may have had some knowledge that maybe he was there?
Well, I think that the United States intelligence has always had this as one of their top targets all the time, and they've always said that they would have it as so with the President Bush's administration, President Obama's as well, and I congratulate President Obama for continuing this fight. It's so important. We've got to do this united as Americans. But it'll be interesting to see what participation the Pakistan intelligence forces and the military had in this American-led operation, which is very tricky for them to have our guys there on the ground. Boots on the ground in Pakistan is never a very popular...
And they said it was only U.S.-led.
That's right.
That's
so it'll be interesting to see how much information we shared, knowing how many terrorist elements and militants and radicals they have in Pakistan, homegrown. Who really dislike their leadership cooperating with the United States.
An incredible operation. Not one soldier was hurt.
And before
not one American.
Before we go,
incredible.
You've seen a lot. You've seen a lot happen. Where does this rank to you?
I think we will always remember where we were the moment that we heard that the Osama bin Laden, our target number one guy for so many years, the man who was responsible for this vicious attack on our country, where we were when we heard this news. It's going to be seared in our memory forever. And I think of all those loved ones who died on September 11th and our men and women who died protecting our freedoms in Iraq and Afghanistan, that their lives will never be forgotten. And our struggle goes on, because many sleeper cells, many other homegrown terrorists are all around us. So we've got to be thankful for our wonderful men and women in uniform.
Yes, we sure. Congresswoman, thank you
so
much for joining us.
Thank you.